Welcome everyone to another InMotion Hosting video. Today we're going to be talking about using the shortcode blocks in your Gutenberg editor. If you're not familiar with shortcodes, or you may be needing to use a shortcode in your site and you're wanting to see how to do it in the new editor, it's really pretty simple. It works very similarly to how shortcodes worked in the previous classic editor. Basically, a shortcode is a snippet of text that you put into a post or a page, and it expands some code to do some additional things and bring in some outside elements, some dynamic elements, more specifically, into a post or page, and then bring it to the front end as well. So basically, we're going to use as an example here the Contact Form 7 plugin, which uses a shortcode to generate a contact form in a post or page. And so we'll go ahead and open a post here that I have ready. And for this example, you'll notice I've already set up a classic editor block here, and I have some basic paragraph text here followed by the shortcode, which is still within a regular paragraph element. And let's actually open this up on the front end so you can see what it does. So you see here, there's my paragraph text. Here's the contact form. And that little shortcode we put in expands this dynamic content or contact form acceptance field here with a name, email, subject, and an optional message. So let's do this in the block editor this time. Let's go back. And let's actually delete this classic editor block here. And before I do that, I better copy that shortcode. All right, we've got our shortcode copied. So here, pretty simply, you can create a new block and call it a shortcode and actually just put in your shortcode right there. And if you go ahead and we'll update the post and we'll refresh it, you'll see when it loads that nothing has changed here except my paragraph text is gone, but the shortcode expands just as it did, as we would expect it to in this block here. And then there's an even easier way to do this. You can actually just paste in the shortcode without even creating the block. And it actually has an extra nice feature here in the Contact Form 7 plugin where it'll detect that you're using a Contact Form 7 shortcode, and you can actually choose which contact form you want to use from a drop-down menu here. I only have one contact form currently, so there's only one option, but that's another convenient way to do it. You can actually just paste in your shortcode. And before we go, I actually wanted to just show you really quick that shortcodes actually work inline as well. So I put some text in here in this paragraph and I put in my shortcode there. When we update the post, this actually still works as well. So it's going to reload it. You see there's the paragraph text and it knows that that was a shortcode because it's inside the brackets and it expands just as we expected it to. So there you go. That's a few different ways to use shortcodes. Nothing to worry about. They work pretty much similarly to the way that they did in the classic editor. So you can enjoy putting in different shortcodes for different purposes in your site. So go ahead, and if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below and give the video a like, and be sure to subscribe to other videos here at InMotion Hosting. Thanks.
Check out our InMotion Hosting Support Center for help with your website. We provide thousands of step-by-step guides, videos, and much more to lead you towards making your online project a successful one. You can find us at www.inmotionhosting.com/support.